It's always interesting to compare an old model with a new one and see what changes have been made from one year to the next. But it's Jeep's 60th birthday. So where did it all start? So this is an original World War II Willys Jeep. The Willys does have, however, some extras that you won't find on today's Jeep, namely a shovel and an axe, just in case things get a little too tough for even a Willys. It's just like somebody's thrown a load of old bed frames and bed skits into a skip and welded a car out of it. Of course, safety isn't what it is now. Apart from being separated by 60 years, the distinctive classic lines of the Willys are clearly echoed in today's newer model. Okay, so the new one is bigger, but they still share the same muscle grille, round headlights, and exposed hinges that give both that all-American rugged appeal. So, can Jeeps today do the same job as they did 60 years ago on the battlefield? Right then, so let's see if this Jeep's cut out to be car crazy! It might be quite basic by modern day standards. I mean, it's got wind up windows, but compared to something 50 years ago, it's quite sophisticated. And it's got a 4-litre engine, so there's no shortage of power when you need it. Okay, so the first handy tip, forget the Paris-Dakar. The trick is to drive as slowly as possible, but as fast as necessary. Driving as slowly as possible helps reduce the damage to the ground, which keeps in with the conservation issues, and it also increases your safety. In a manual, it's really important that once you've changed gear, you take your foot off the clutch and put it on the floor. This reduces the risk of you dropping the clutch involuntarily and putting the vehicle into freefall. It's really important that you keep your fingers and thumbs on the outside rim of the steering wheel. This keeps them out of danger because if you're going to hit a rock or a tree stump, the force of the spin of the wheel could easily break your thumbs if they're in the wrong place. Sometimes when you're driving off-road, it's very difficult to judge where you're going to be going if you look through the windscreen. However, if you lean out the window, you can see the front tyres and you can quite clearly point the vehicle in the direction you really want to be going. The chassis is pretty rugged and the axle has a huge amount of articulation. And of course, it has a reasonably sophisticated four-wheel drive system. Now it might look like a bit of a poser's car, it is an image thing. Let's face it, most of us aren't going to take this thing off-road Davy Crockett style to hunt for caribou. Well, that said, it's quite competent off-road because it does have all the right tackle to do the job. So, 60 years on and the Jeep hasn't lost any of its rugged appeal, and I'm sure that if it was called into battle, it could still tackle the job. So I salute my old friend, the Jeep. Carry on, Lieutenant.